Well, it's that time of year again when Autodesk starts releasing the next iteration of all of its products. This one being Advanced Steel 2023. So let's jump right in and see what's new. Here are the enhancements I'm going to share with you today. The improvements have been made to beam creation, cameras, the AISC shapes, the document manager, the grid display, heaters for bolt labels, drawing deregistration, and overall performance. I know this slide has a lot on it, so don't worry about remembering it all now. You'll see each one of these in turn. The first enhancement today involves converting polylines into beams. Although this feature already exists, it has been extended to include single segment polylines. This can come in handy if you need to convert a drawing that may have been started in regular AutoCAD, maybe in 2D, which will make the process much quicker when going from single lines to finished drawings. Let's see it in action. We already know how easy it is to create beams in Advanced Steel. It's just like drawing lines. In the event you already have some lines drawn to represent your beams, you can use the beam from polyline command to convert those into beams. This can greatly reduce your picks and clicks, thus getting the steel completed more quickly. And the quicker we can do this, the sooner we get to create our drawings. Now, this feature is not new. So those of you who have been using Advanced Steel for a while might already be aware. For you newer people, this is still worth mentioning. Second enhancement is probably my favorite. We now are able to display the grids on upper levels in drawings. A new property has been added that allows us to project grids in the vertical direction in the model. In previous releases, we had to copy the grids to the upper levels in order for them to appear on those drawings. Let's see that in action. For existing grids, go to Advanced Properties and then the Grid Projection tab. Check the box to project the grid vertically for model views and drawings. From now on, the grid will be visible in model views and camera views. As a result, grids can be made visible in plan views that are higher in elevation than where the grid was created in the model. I'll create a drawing based on a camera view so you can see the result. Just got to set up the type of view here. As you can see, the grid is included on the upper level drawing. So no more copying grids to upper levels in your model. Okay, the next enhancement is a feature that enables you to use search queries to select objects for a camera view. We're already able to select objects to include in a camera, but this is a nice addition to the feature. If you have any search queries already created in the Project Explorer, you can now leverage those. as I mentioned, this feature previously allowed you to manually specify objects to include in camera views. You can still select individual objects to include. You'll do that using the Select Objects button in the camera dialog. You can also remove objects from that selection. In Advanced Steel 2023, the new search query option enables you to quickly select objects for your camera views using one or more of those predefined search queries. All those queries are displayed in the drop-down list in the same order as in the Project Explorer. And you can use the Mark Objects button from here. That'll highlight the selected objects in red. And several of these options have been relocated to the camera properties just for convenience, such as the clear marking button. And elements that are added to a camera through a query, but they're outside the camera's viewport, will not appear in the camera view. So I think we get the best of both worlds on this one. And remember, you can utilize the drawing process from inside the camera to automate the drawing creation. And this feature is also available for cameras that are used directly from a model view in the Project Explorer. So this enhancement makes it easier and faster to create 2D camera views from your model. Here's another enhancement to cameras: independent grips. Resizing the camera is much easier now because there are grips on each side of the camera box. In previous releases, a camera's XY viewport could still be resized using grips. However, these adjustments were symmetric. If you stretch the right side of the viewport, for example, the left side would move an equal distance. In 2023, this behavior's improved because now there's grips on both sides and they operate independently. So you can stretch the right side, for example, and the left side remains unaffected. So this gives us even more control when we're modifying the size of cameras. The next enhancement to Advanced Steel 2023 is the updated steel profiles in accordance with the 15th edition of the AISC Shapes database. The latest profiles have been added, and obsolete profiles have been renamed using the ZZZ 2023 prefix. Connection defaults used in parametric steel connections have been updated as well. Mapping tables have also been updated to provide a smoother experience when transferring a model between Advanced Steel and Revit using the Advanced Steel extension for Revit 2023. The next enhancement is in the Document Manager. In short, we can now leave it open while working on models and drawings. In Advanced Steel 2023, the Document Manager adopts a modeless behavior, meaning that it remains open for use at any time during a session. For example, you can review information about parts in the model, or even access the tools in the ribbon to create your drawings while the Document Manager remains open. If you create any documents while it's open, the newly created ones appear in the document manager without having to close and reopen it. And once the drawings have been created, the icon on the lower left corner of the dialog serves as a reminder to check the status of your documents. When you make changes to your model, such as adjusting the number of bolts for a connection, clicking on this icon will move any affected drawings to the update required category. And from there, you can update them automatically. Now, there are a few features that are unavailable while you're editing a drawing, such as force update, update revision, revision and change prototype. When you open multiple projects at the same time, the model name is displayed in the title bar of the dialog so that you can easily associate the documents to the correct project. Next, labels. They're already pretty flexible in advanced steel. Now that extends to bolt labels. If you move a label around a group of bolts, the arrow of the leader line automatically jumps to the closest bolt, creating a shorter leader and making the drawing more readable. You can disable this new behavior by deselecting the option automatic leader line position for labels on bolts in the properties dialog. In addition, the arrowhead of the leader line now remains on the outside of the bolt, which should improve the drawing clarity. The bottom line, you have more control over labels than in previous releases. As you can see here, when you drag a bolt label to a new location, the leader line adjusts to the nearest bolt. If you want the leader line to remain where it is, or have manual control over which bolt the leader is attached to, you can disable this behavior in the label properties. And the leader remains on the outside of the bolt. Okay, next enhancement, Advanced Steel 2023 brings two changes to how automatic document deregistration is handled for files that are not available or not found. These changes complement the modification from 2022 with files not available on disk no longer being deregistered when opening the document manager. In 2023, a new default is available in management tools that turns on and off the automatic deregistration of missing documents when the document manager does a status check. By turning off this default, the 2022 behavior is brought back, and those files are no longer deregistered, but instead will appear in the unknown category of the document manager. Also, there is a new command on the document manager ribbon, and that allows for manual deregistration of the unknown documents. And after using that command, the list of all the deregistered files will be displayed on the command line. So by introducing a dedicated command in this release, This action is removed from the audit command compared to 2022. Bottom line here, these enhancements will help with more flexibility on deregistering those missing documents. And there's one more enhancement I'd like to share with you today. It was introduced in AutoCAD 2022, the graphics system fabric. It's a cross-platform 3D graphics system designed to harness the power of modern GPUs and multi-core CPUs. Advanced Steel 2023 adds support for GSF, thus enabling a smoother navigation experience with larger 3D models. So this functionality is enabled by default for the shaded and shaded with edges visual styles. The bottom line, with this addition, Advanced Steel will offer better visual performance when navigating those large and complex projects. In closing, today we looked at enhancements for creating beams from polylines, grips and search queries for cameras, the updates to the AISC shapes, the new Modeless document manager, the new grid display, bolt labels, automatic deregistration, and overall performance, all of which should improve your productivity by making Advanced Steel easier to use. Okay, that wraps up today's presentation. Here are our resources that you can take advantage of for self-help. On our YouTube channel, you'll find the recordings for all our previous webcasts. This one will be available shortly. Plus, we have plenty of articles on our blog at hagerman.com with additional content for customers on our customer hub. For more in-depth assistance, you can contact us at Hagerman for specific needs and training.